Welcome to the Just KNIME It Recap. If you haven't heard of Just KNIME It before, we provide you with a weekly data science problem and challenge you to solve it with a KNIME workflow. In the recap, I'll give you some of my thoughts on the problem and highlight some of the solutions from the community on the KNIME Forum. So, last week's challenge was on some real estate analytics, specifically in the Seattle housing market. Now, I don't live in Seattle, but I am a recently new homeowner, and the housing market in the US has definitely been interesting in the last 5 years. There's a lot to balance when you're trying to find a new home, trying to balance location with home size, with yard size, with work commutes, and all of these different things, along with the price, of course. And let's see if anybody from the community has been able to develop a analytics solution with KNIME that might make this a little bit easier. So first, let's look at the challenge. You're a real estate agent working in a new city, and to perform well, your first task is to understand the houses in the region better. A colleague shares a data set with you, and now it's time for you to explore it. What has been the average housing price, lot size, and living space in this city, according to the data set? How are prices distributed and correlated with housing features? What other insights can you gather from the data set? Okay, so the first solution I want to look at is by Carlos Enrique. So his dashboard here, this one's nice. It's fairly simple. We're looking at the different prices. We're looking at the lot sizes. We see the living space in these different histograms. But one of the cool features that you get to explore with this dashboard here is the interactivity. You'll notice that there's a table down here that shows some of the houses. If I click on these different boxes or bars in the histograms in these bars charts above, it changes the filter and shows me different houses in that table below. So this is a really cool way to demonstrate how you can build an interactive dashboard with KNIME. Now, the next solution I want to show is by somebody that we've shown a solution from before, actually, Sriyu. So Sriyu's dashboard is really nice. Again, it's showing some bar charts using the KNIME nodes. Nothing crazy as far as beautification goes here. Very interesting to see the distribution of the housing prices, along with some correlation between the price and the other features. But what I think is particularly cool about Sriyu's solution here is that he chose to train a tree ensemble model and report on some of the feature importance from that model. And before doing that, he also gives us some information about the performance of that model. Because for the feature importance to matter, we need the model to be accurate, right? So one of the things that we see here is what kind of things contribute most to the value of a home. So this first one up top, the zip code, makes a lot of sense to me. There are expensive neighborhoods, there are cheaper neighborhoods, and that seems to be a big part of what makes a house expensive. Waterfront, sure, absolutely, I'd love a lake house. And it goes down like that. And I think this is a really great way to show the value of a tool like KNIME, where you can combine functionality of machine learning along with some of these simple dashboards. So great solution. Now the third solution I want to show is from a user named Annex. Annex actually showed three dashboards, but I'm going to show you the first one. So Annex is actually the only user from these three that chose to use the geospatial extension to demonstrate some of this information on the real estate market here in Seattle. So you'll see that we actually have these maps, and there's two maps here. One shows price, and one shows the lot size. So this one gives you an idea of where you can find houses with big yards, clearly farther from the city center. And this one gives you ideas of where you can find expensive houses or cheaper houses. This is kind of interesting to me in particular, because if there's a specific part of town that I enjoy or I want to live in, I can kind of explore here a little bit and see where I can find maybe some pockets of affordability. And that's really cool too, if I'm looking to make some compromises. But he goes on and produces a few more charts here with the geospatial extension. So this is just another really cool way to incorporate some of the additional functionality of KNIME extensions. All right, follow us on social media, use the hashtag JustKNIME It, submit your solutions, and we'll see you next week for the next challenge. Thank you.